of the gate.
Yeah, but she's got the coach auto open close.
And he doesn't.
And there's the approach. And she hits the...
Now, from News 7 Sports. This is the Norv Turner Coaches Show.
Work hard last week, and this week it paid off.
How well we played, and we know that we should have been. The record should be a lot better. But the thing we're gonna have to do is learn how to, you know, come together as a team and win the games we're supposed to win.
Lose games in the past, and, you know, fortunately this time it helped us win. That's how you need turnovers to win games.
The key to our defense is turnovers. I believe we have four, maybe five turnovers. So fortunately, when he made the fumble, the bounce right in my arms was the easy thing to do.
I was really looking forward to this game, and didn't play very well, and kind of was, you know, a situation, put ourselves in a bad situation.
How are you? Merry Christmas to you. Merry Christmas.
Congratulations, Coach. Big win over the Rams, 35-23. But was this a case of the team winning ugly, so to speak?
There's no such thing as winning ugly. When you've been through a season like we've been, you know, a week ago we totally dominate New York in all statistical areas, and I think physically, and lose a football game. So winning is the key. If you can win a football game, it doesn't matter how you do it. It
comes down to the W's in this case.
Absolutely.
When you look at Heath Shuler's situation, he goes down yesterday, the last play of the first half, steps on with the pinky. Is he out this week?
Yeah, it doesn't look like he'll be able to play this week, which is very unfortunate. I thought... Heath was as comfortable as he's been. He played awfully well in the first half. You're in a noisy stadium. Around him, we were unsettled. We jumped off sides a couple of times, had penalties, and he was kind of the stabilizing factor. Threw the ball up the field awfully well and moved the football team.
Talk about the game again. Heck of a ball game. You guys are down 10-0 at one point. Didn't run off 28 unanswered points.
We were playing a team that... we get in there on Saturday, and Saturday night we get a chance to see the news, the coaches show, and they're hyped up, and they're talking about having a chance to be a playoff team. If they win their last two and certain things happen, they can be in the playoffs. So we're playing a team that I think is ready to play and a good football team, and I think that says something for our team to go in there, be ready to play. We get down by 10, no one panic. We come back, go ahead, put a nice drive together, score, defensively score. And did a lot of good things in the football game. They did the same thing to us. They did to Buffalo the week before. They went no huddle in the fourth quarter, spread them out. They scored twice against Buffalo in the fourth quarter. They've got weapons, and they can move the football. They get in that no huddle circumstance.
You talk about the coaches show on Saturday night, watching that in St. Louis. Did that hype the team up? Did that upset you guys? It seems like, hey, we're going to the playoffs. We're going to take care of the Redskins.
Well, I don't know if it did or not. I think most of our guys were watching the Tyson fight. I'm probably the only guy that was watching the coaches' show.
Coming up later on the North Turner Coaches Show, we will relax with defensive end Tony Wood. But up next, it's time to break down the plays to help make Washington's day. Stay tuned.
The Norv Turner Coaches Show is brought to you by your friends at Toyota.
Toyota truck. I'll take my big Toyota too. There's far and wide and low and high, for I've broken down, but it's new. Could have had a bigger payload, more power and savings too. But it chose instead this truck to stand, and the lack of value blue.
Simply the best.
Yeah, that's some kind of rock, all right.
Boston Market introduces Hearth Honey Hams for the holidays. Questions, anyone?
Do you use the finest boneless ham?
Oh, yeah!
Are you blending the honey with
ham for a location near you?
One thing about Sunday's game on offense, you guys really went into the playbook to come up with some innovative things to do on Sunday. Take a look at the one play, the shuffle pass that scores for Brian Mitchell.
Well, the shovel pass, it's been a play. It was a big play for us against Dallas a couple of weeks ago. One of the reasons it's become more of a play for us in the second half of the season, with he's in the offense, we are rolling out more. We are drop rolling, and defenses have to contain us. Now you find ends running up the football field. The coaches are saying, hey, don't let Shuler get outside of the pocket. Now you have a chance. In this particular play, we give a formation with Henry Ellard in the slot, and we get fortunate. They like the blitz off the slot, so we felt if we did get the blitz, by putting him in motion, we would ensure the blitz was to the back side of where we're running the ball. We put Henry Ellard in motion and go through, and you see the blitzer stays and comes from the back side. So he's coming away from where we want to run the football. As the play develops now, we'll stop it right here, and you see what's happened. The ends run up the field. The ends run up the field, which allows Brian Mitchell a heck of a lane. Jamie Asher, the tight end, we'll run it back here for a second. Jamie Asher starts like he's going to block the end to influence him, runs up the field and blocks the linebacker. We'll stop it right. He's on the linebacker. Now the guard's able to come around and get the next defender, and then you have a runner like Brian Mitchell. He's going to make the most of the play as he goes. Mm-hmm. And you get a great look at it here. And even a better look as we continue. We'll look at it from the end zone shot, and you'll see the dynamics of everything we're talking about. The end is going to be influenced and run up the field. Jamie's going to crack on the linebacker, on the linebacker. The end runs up the field, allowing Brian Mitchell a lane, and there's an alley, and he just follows Ray Brown, the guard. As you watch here, the end's up the field. Here's Ray coming around, and Brian Mitchell follows him through the scene.
What makes this play work? Is it the fact that Brian Mitchell can run the way he does, or is it the fact that your quarterback is mobile and it has to be respected?
Well, it's a combination of the whole deal. The end's going to run up the field. Then we get a great block by Jamie Asher. We get a great block by Ray Brown. And you find a way to get the ball to someone like Brian Mitchell. Brian Mitchell's going to make extra things happen when he gets the ball in his hand.
That's why he's in the Pro Bowl now. Let's talk defense now. Marcus Patton has a huge game, 15 solo tackles, but I think no play bigger than the one he makes here.
Well, it's a real big play he makes, but again, with Marcus Patton, this game was not the exception for him. He has played really for seven straight weeks at that type of level. He's been in double figures in tackles almost every game. He's comfortable with what we're doing defensively. I think early in the year he was a little hesitant. He was a little uncertain. He's playing. He knows exactly what he's doing. He's playing with confidence, and he's going after people. And he's the player that we thought we were getting from Buffalo, and he's playing at that high a level. We're in a three-man line, and then we move Ken Harvey late outside. That's to get a four-man rush and try to get a little different look. They do a good job with the protection. They pick it up. We're in a zone. We're in a zone, and Marcus drops off here. He's looking at his receiver but looking through to see the quarterback. When the ball's thrown, he gets a great break on it. Bang. There's the hit. The ball squirts out, and Tony's in a great situation. We had this same thing come up in that first New York game where the ball gets batted, and it goes right to their guy. Here's the crossing route. there's the hit, the ball squirts, and Tony's in the right place at the right time, and we're deserving of these type of situations. Mm-hmm. And we've had a couple of these go against us this year. In this game, we had them go our way.
Defense actually scored twice in the game. Tom Carter with a big interception.
Tom, I thought that was the big play in the game. I thought it was big when it's 10-0 that offensively we were able to drive the football, but then to step up defensively and make that kind of play, it's a third down play, and again, we've seen those third and three, 4-5, where they convert and they go down and score. Mm-hmm. Well, this time he throws the ball a little bit too far out in front. Tom's in perfect position, catches the football and makes a play.
Coming up next on the North Turner Coaches Show, it is time to relax and cool out. We take a whirlpool bath with the Triple Vent, Tony Wood. Stay tuned.
Sometimes little things say a lot, like this clip.
Oh. Want it all? Now Pizza Hut offers our Lover's Line topping. Meat Lovers, Pepperoni Lovers, or Supreme. Piled high in a stuffed crust pizza.
So what'll it be, Dion? 15, 20 million?
Both.
Both. You'll love the stuff we're made of.
Hey, I'm an old quarterback, Jack Kemp, and you are with me.
North Turner, what show?
My name is Dannigan. I'm Art Monk.
And you're watching the North Turner Coaches Show on TV7.
I'm Art Monk, and you're watching the North Turner Coaching Show on News Channel 7.
Coaches Show.
Okay, North Turner Coaches Show. Okay.
I'm Tom Landry, and you're watching the Norm Turner Show on TV7.
Oh, North. What about, I'm Jean-Claude Van Damme, and you're watching, you have anything else for the show as a name?
You think it took Ronald Reagan this many takes?
North Culture Show.
TV7, huh?
Hi, I'm Jean-Claude Van Damme on Channel 7 to watch the best show. Yeah, Merry Christmas. That's enough for you?
I'm Tom Landry, and you're watching the North Turner. He's coaching coach. I can't even do that.
Richard, write down on a piece of paper this gentleman's show. Yeah, here.
Hi, I'm John Robinson, and you're watching the North Turner Show on Channel 7. Hi, I'm John Robinson.
Turner, and then show.
Okay, I'm Tom Landry, and you're watching Norm Turner, coach's show on Channel 7.
N-O-R, North Turner. Turner.
I'm Art Monk, and you're watching the North Turner coaching show on Channel 7.
Hi, this is Jean-Claude Van Damme. You're going to get a kick. North Turner Show. No. Okay. Ready, guys? Hi, this is Jean-Claude Van Damme. You're going to watch the North Turner Show. Merry Christmas! Yeah! That's it. Next.
You ever think that your name was that hard to pronounce?
Well, listen, it may be funny to you guys, but I've been having to live this thing all my life, so I don't find this real humorous.
Did it take you a while to get your own name?
No, I've been able to pronounce it for a long time, but people do. I usually Norm, they say Norman, Norb, you know, I mean.
Yeah, I've said Norm a couple of times, too, I think, when you first started out. Tony Wood, no one mistakes how to pronounce this guy's name, and for a while there, the defensive line was somewhat of a liability for the Redskins. Things seem to have improved quite a bit lately.
Well, Tony Woods has never been a liability for us. You know, he's a guy that has, I don't think anyone's going to look and say, hey, that's a great football player, but he's a very good football player, and he's played at a high level for us the 2 years he's been here, and he's one of the free agents that people seem to always forget to mention that we've signed. It's been really a big plus for us.
Well, earlier today, Coach, I got an opportunity to kick back with Tony Woods in the whirlpool.
All right, Tony, is this Monday morning therapy?
Typically, you know, after a tough game, especially on turf, we got 3 games of turf, and the knees and ankles start to hurt, so this is typical Monday.
Yesterday didn't hurt that much, though, did it? Because you got the big touch yet.
There's John and Tim. Get them going right to work. Put Rosani. He has Pinson at the 10. He fumbles the ball. The Redskins have a touchdown. It's picked up by Tony Wood.
I was very surprised because we supposed to run to the ball after the quarterback throws it, and the ball ricocheted right into my hand, and I had about 2 yards to go, so it was easy to touch that once I had help up to the ball. But
did that somewhat give some respect back to the defensive line?
I think so, because over the past 4 or 5 weeks, we've played good defense.
Out of the pocket, Westbrook's ripping, and down he goes. Good down. play, and it is for nothing.
How did you feel earlier in the year when some of the controversy came out with some of your own teammates just saying, defensive line is not doing the job?
I didn't like it. We spoke to the guys personally about it, but we felt like going into the season that the defensive line was the weakest part of the defense. We knew that, but we felt like as time went on and the younger guys started to grow up and understand what the game is all about, that everything would work out well. So we really didn't need that distraction, and it probably worked in a positive way when you look at it. The defensive line is playing better since that.
Did you personally step things up?
Personally, I did, and I talked to the younger guys because they were actually more heated than I was, because I've been around long enough not to worry about things like that. So I talked to them and got their heads straight that we have to control what we can do, and it worked out well for us.
Do you feel like the old man on the squad? I mean, I'm looking at the beard here. I see some gray hairs in there. Now you got all these young guys now with Nottage and Gaines and Owens. Do you feel like the old man of the group?
Yeah, I do. I'm still only 30, so I'm like, I'm not old. Yeah.
That actually makes you younger than me, so I've got to watch that stuff.
Oh, here comes Kid Gotti. Kid Gotti. A fumble and recovered by the Redskins and Ken Harvey.
How does the defense get better? I mean, you guys have improved. Yes, there are some things that you need, like a pass rush. How do you do that? I mean, there's only one game to go. How do you get it for this last game?
Well, I think it's the last game. I think we want to end up with a two-game winning streak. We have a lot of things we're trying to win. It's a home game, final game. A lot of people complex up, so you're going to try to play well as you can also. There's going to be some decisions that have to be made when the season's over with. But it's just the character inside of you. You don't want to go out there and just walk around the field. Mm-hmm. We have the things we need to get done as a defense, and I think everybody will be fired up for it. I think the nucleus is here. We have a lot of good young guys that's really starting to learn how to play with a good mixture of veterans, and that's why I hope I'm here with the team next year, you know, a couple more years after that, because I see us going up, and I want to be a part of it, because I mean, Noah was a great coach, and I want to be a part of it because I believe within 3 years, Redskins will be in the Super Bowl.
Hey! All right, well, anyway, thank you very much for allowing me to spend some time here at the Jacuzzi with the game ball to you, man, for the touchdown.
Thank you.
Great play. Coming up next on the North Turner Show, Coach's Show, it is time to pay off the Monday Night Wager. Stay tuned.
While we had the 85 Camry, we put 3 kids through school, moved twice, and had 3 presidents. 2 since I made
a brother label maker. I could use that. All right, a brother fax. Oh, a brother printer. A water gun.
Busted.
Get brother products at the guaranteed low price and 6,000 other great gift ideas. Sable, yeah, we've got that.
The Norv Turner Coaches Show is brought to you by your friends at Toyota.
From 1960 until 1966, Fran O'Brien blocked for some of the greatest offensive stars of all time.
Our day, you had to play both ways sometimes, and you had to do a lot of things. But today, if you can just do one real good thing, they'll keep you on a roster.
Today, his tie says it all. He's made his way back to Washington and reopened Fran O'Brien's Steakhouse inside the Capitol Hilton Hotel.
When I was with the Redskins, I played 10 years in the NFL. It's always been the perception that football players ate a lot. Mm-hmm. So I decided to make this a steakhouse because, again, the perception of the public is that players eat a lot and they want big portions, and that's what we give you at Fran O'Brien's.
Besides the fine food, the restaurant is full of history. It's also home to the oldest sports hall of fame in America, the Touchdown Club of Washington. Nagurski. Thorpe. United. Hey! Riggin.
Just a little bit of soul.
Allen. Mitchell. Taylor. Battle. Ball. And Brown. All have a home.
I can just see Sonny going back in the split seconds. I mean, he would make a decision and fire that ball probably better than any other quarterback that I've ever seen. I look at these pictures and I see George Marshall. That was my first boss when I was with the Redskins. He said the difference between good and great is a little extra effort. And George had that same philosophy, and I've always remembered that there's no substitute for hard work.
Fran O'Brien works out perfectly here because he has offered to allow us to come down for dinner at his place to kind of pay off our little Monday night wager. For the folks who may not remember this, on the line we had a limo ride and dinner for two. At this point, I have no chance of winning thing at all.
Let's make this thing interesting and competitive.
Okay.
I only got one condition. Now, we'll go. You've won five in a row, and you've made a nice, strong showing to come back into it. So let's just go. Everything rides on this week's game.
This is it.
And the only condition is you have to pick first.
That's not fair. Every time I do that, I lose.
Well, that's okay. Then you can just take the loss without the
gamble. I'm going to gamble on this one. Okay, we got Minnesota and San Francisco. I'll go with San Francisco.
I thought you might do that.
And why do you always
And for
that?
Once, I agree with you. So if both of us agree, since I've lost 5 weeks in a row picking first, I think I'm in pretty good shape with Minnesota.
Dennis Green will be very happy with you because you went with him this time around. Coach, you got the final game coming up this weekend against Carolina. Is this something that you guys need to win going to the offseason feeling pretty good?
I think it's really an important game for us. I'm going to talk to our team about it. We hope to be in this situation. I know the teams I've been on over the years have gone to playoffs. When you play the last football game, you're playing for either home field advantage, you're playing to win your division, you're playing for to be a wild card team. Mm-hmm. But any team I've been on, the last game has been important in terms of where you go into the playoffs. I'd like to be in that situation next year. I'd like to create that atmosphere this year and make the Carolina game that type of game, and it's a game we need to go win.
All right, Coach. Best of luck this weekend against Carolina. That does it for the North Turner Coaches Show. We'll see you next Monday night, and until then, have a happy holiday season. Yeah!